Hey guys, so welcome to my channel. So I haven't done one of these videos for a while, and so today I want to do a share a recipe. And so it is like a chicken stir fry, something basic. And so right now I got some oil heating on the pan, and this is the canola oil. And then so I already got some rice going on. It's already ready, the rice. Smells amazing. And then here's my chicken. I used the salt, pepper, garlic powder, and onion powder mixed in there. And then I got some snap peas and celery for the veggies. And I'm using these as shred carrots. And I'm using these lazy onions. How much grams is this? I don't know. I don't know. And then the sauce I'm using today is this honey garlic sauce. So I think I'm gonna use the whole bottle because I like it more saucy. And so I think the oil is bubbling and it looks like it is hot enough. I haven't done one of these for a while. And so first, when I do these stir fries, I usually put in the onion first because they smell amazing. This canola oil got this a bright yellow color. I'm gonna make the whole place smell like onion. If you guys wonder why there's a furnace right there, it's that I moved to a basement suite and it's my new place right now. So right now, gonna let the onion goes sizzling on its own and do its own thing for a while, and we'll be right back. Sizzle, sizzle. So this is the way I want the onions to look like. It is like starting to brown up and caramelize. Looks like a fried onions, and the place smells amazing. And so next, I'm gonna add the chicken. Because the onion, the aroma, because the aroma of the onions will get into the chicken, so that's why I do that. So the chicken goes in next. Just watch it go. So now we are gonna let the chicken cook for a few minutes, and so to make sure it is all thoroughly cooked and so we do not get ourselves raw chicken. So let it sizzling in the pan there for a bit, and yeah, the fire alarm is so funny. The chicken is ready, so I sampled some of the chicken to make sure they are cooked. And so now it's to put in the celery and the snap peas because they do not take very long to cook. So I'm gonna dump in these veggies. I'm gonna throw in the carrots as well. Like the The carrots is gonna add a level of sweetness for the everything. So now I'm just gonna let this hang out for a few minutes.
Oh my gosh. This thing is too big for the pan.
So now it is ready, and so I do not want to overcook the snap peas because I like them snappy. And so now just gonna add the sauce, the honey garlic sauce. So I'm just gonna add all of it because this is a larger batch. So yeah, so you guys just adjust the recipe as needed. And usually I shake it up with some water to wash off the rest of the bottle. Oh, I'm tired. So now I'm just gonna mix this around and just to stir it all up, and it's gonna be ready to go. Hey guys, so this is what the finished stir fry looks like, and so those as sauces, those type of product, they usually thicken up because they got like cornstarch and whatever in the sauces usually. So it's looking very beautiful colors, and the snap peas, they look very beautiful colors. And so it is ready to plate up now because I'm hungry. As you guys can see, I'm alive, and like my cooking is so amazing, right? It just sets off alarms. It's like, I hope there's not a bunch of firemen waiting at the door. But you know, it's like, I do not see any type of alarm system or some type of automatic. Those type of, because you know, like a lot of people these days have those automatic systems. It's like when the alarm goes off, it connects with the police station or fire station right away. But like when I moved in here, I did not see any of that. So I'm a little bit annoyed though, because when I bought that big bowl, it's like when you saw that pasta video last time, so the big bowl is like very tall, and so I have to think up of some way of setup, because the way with the bowl is like almost covering my face. The rice is done perfectly. For me, when I make rice, like, I do not like my rice to be too wet or too soggy. As I always, make my rice a little bit dry. I always add a little bit less water to my rice. That is what I like. Like the honey garlic sauce, it adds a little bit level of sweetness to the dish. Man, it's like I have not cooked like this for a while. I'll feed you some rice. And you know, it's like because I think the main reason is ever since that incident back in August, it kind of really messed up my emotions and stuff like that. It's like I never really kind of gotten out of the emotions. So, now I'm starting to try to cook more, and I just filmed the shopping haul video. A lot of you guys been asking. I haven't done one forever. Do you guys like this angle? Like at this grocery store today, it's like they sell the chicken breast like in a very big long package or the smaller package. It's like I look at the prices. It's like a big long package is almost $40, and it's only average about six or seven pieces for $40 almost. And I bought the smaller pack of two for like $10 something each, and I bought two packs, and it's like 20 something bucks, like about the same price. Like, even the good old chicken breast is so effing expensive. Like, they used to say, the chicken thighs, the chicken legs, the bone, the chicken bone breast, the chicken breast with bone in it is cheaper price because they have the bone in it, and the chicken breast, the boneless, you are paying more because they take out the bone for you. But these days, everything is about the same price. And sometimes, when I go into some stores, sometimes the stuff that they sell is they sell those marinated chickens. They want you to buy the marinated chickens. The whole shelf is all full of them. I am so excited to go to work tomorrow because I'm gonna pack this for lunch tomorrow because I got a full shift tomorrow. So at the Safeway is the one that I go to the store that I buy those salads at. The salads that you guys see me eat. So I was wanting to do salad, but then I'm like, it's like I want to try to make a hot meal. Like I haven't made a hot meal in a long time. Like when you guys add the carrots to the stir fry, the carrots, it adds a level of sweetness to the dish. It's very like extra layers of flavor. The brand of the sauce that I showed you guys, they have a teriyaki sauce, but I've tried it before, but I do not like it. It's just got a weird taste to it. I go for the Kikkoman, they sell the Kikkoman, the teriyaki sauce. I prefer that one more. So today for Sunday is like the weather for this weekend. I am very blessed right now that I decided to move in early a few days because right now since on Friday the weather is changing and it's starting to snow in, and so moving and snowing is not a good idea. So I moved in 3 days early before the end of the month, and I'm so lucky. But today I've just been very lazy and I've just been listening to music on YouTube all day. It's like I have not unpacked at all. It's like I just took out a box just to get out the cast iron pan. So right now at my new place here, it is very nice, and however, the only nasty thing is at the kitchen, like whoever that was here before had some long Asian hair. There's a long Asian hair everywhere. Like seriously, like it's even longer than mine. Like I know it's not my hair. So nasty. And then right now, for now, it's like the first few nights in this place. They have the upstairs roommate, they have the downstairs roommate. So right now, the upstairs roommate is very respectful. They do not come downstairs to bother us or anything, and vice versa. So we do not bother each other. Like, the only chick that I've seen was the black chick. I had a little bit of conversation with her, and everybody else is going to work or going to school. I've just talked to the one black chick, and I know who the landlord is, and everybody is working, and nobody is bothering anybody. It's like the crazy house I was in before. It's like from one extreme to the other. And at the other house I was at before, they claim that they did the renovations by themselves. And so they did the hardwood floors throughout the house, and they must have done it wrong because the hardwood floors is squeaking, squeaking, squeaking. So every time if you want to have some sleep or if you want to sleep in, it's like you hear somebody go to the toilet or something, you're gonna hear the squeaking, squeaking, squeaking. It's like so effing annoying. But this house is you do not hear anything, and the only thing you notice is when somebody is cooking, then you can smell their cooking. However, though, the only thing I'm worried about when I'm living in the basement is that I have to be very careful because sometimes I have the very early shift in the morning to go to for work, and the lighting in the basement is not very good, so I have to remember to wake up in the morning. Sometimes I like to sleep in, you know. It is not like the upper levels when there's more sunlight. My question of the day is, has any of my viewers rented a basement suite before or anything like that? And do you guys like it? So the one thing that I'm a little bit worried about is the idea just got into my head. It's like with the fire alarm that happened earlier in the video. So nobody from upstairs heard it or whatever, but there's probably nobody upstairs and like nobody ran down here to come to my rescue or to ask me if I'm doing okay or something. Like, I wonder what it's gonna be like if it's like a real, if it's like a real emergency. Like, I hope somebody's gonna come down here and rescue me. Right now, the only holiday thing that I'm doing for the holiday season this year is I went to my work Christmas party, and so I do not know if my cousin or if my other family is going to be doing anything. So for me, it's going to be a very quiet holiday season. It's like I do not need to shopping for anybody, and right now for me, I rent a room, so I cannot buy too many stuff. I really have to be careful because I have to keep my stuff in my room. Like, even for cooking, it's like the mentality of the cooking is like the roommates, they do not share the food and stuff like that. And so I got a mini fridge now, so I keep my fresh food in my fridge, and it's like the spices and whatnot is like everything. Every time I want to cook something, I have to take stuff out of my room, and it's like very, very weird mentality. Like, I used to be the home ownership, right? When I used to be the bitch of my own place, huh? Like, when you're sharing with roommates, it's like if you leave something out in the open, there's a very high chance that they might borrow things. But like I say, these roommates, they seem pretty nice so far. Everybody's at work and I rarely see them. So, yeah. If you guys have any dramatic roommate stories to share with me in the comments, feel free to share with me some roommate stories. So right now, this location I'm staying at right now is a very nice location, and I really do hope to be staying here for over a year at least. And I always have to get the idea out of my head is because when me and my ex was in the house together, we was a brand new house, and we were the first owners of the house, and all of these other older, the rental houses or whatever, they are all older houses, so it's a different quality. So I have to not set my standards so high. So right now, I just have to be very blessed and content, and I found a place with cheap rent, and I just have to deal with it. Stir fry is a pretty good way for Sunday dinner, isn't it? This is a very nice hot meal. I haven't had a nice hot meal like this in a long time, huh? I cannot believe it. The first real meal I cook in this house, I set the fire alarm. Oh yes, and also in the recipe, when I chopping the celery, I wash and I rinse the celery, of course. I think the sauce is really, really rich and flavorful. Thank you. That was a nice, satisfying meal. This last few days, I've been very naughty with burgers and stuff like that. Oh, and so you guys, since I'm not really talking about holiday stuff much, talking about burgers, Dairy Queen has the Candy Cane Blizzard out right now, and I took some pictures a few days ago, and I'm going to show it to you here somewhere. The Candy Cane Blizzard is actually not bad, and festive and holiday for the festive season, and so, yeah, so if you guys like Candy Cane, you should check out the Candy Cane Blizzard for sure. Because, if you let me choose a McDonald's McFlurry or a Dairy Queen Blizzard, I would hands down go to Dairy Queen any day, because McDonald's, they do not have very much of flavor selections for you, so that's what pisses me off about McDonald's. So yeah, so Dairy Queen, the Candy Cane Blizzard is very good, so gonna tip you guys off about that. So yeah, so hope you guys have a wonderful week and have a wonderful holiday season, and don't forget to check out all my other older videos on my playlist on my channel, and I'm gonna see you in the next one.